Probably Jim goes, guys won't use you in deep work if they don't think that it's right for you or if you don't sort of take to it. It's a question that is a cooperation or nothing. But I think you'd agree that if we are going to take on trance, there must be a reason. And the reason is that the spirit very often like to get through things to us. There's no way worded by the medium and some of the medium there, because in communication we receive and then it's left to us to interpret. So we don't sort of be told every word that we have to say to you. So very often there's a little bit of a medium there in all that we give. In trance we try to avoid it. That's why trance is used. So that the medium does not control what is said. And in the normal work, the medium is in complete command because they interpret it as they want to interpret it. When it comes to trance work, the idea is to get as deep as you can so that what is said comes from the spirit and the medium is really involved. It's a lazy mediumship, really. I always think, because when I'm going, I think so, I miss it, because I like the gossip. we like to hear what's going on, and with trance you don't. Sometimes you think you do. Afterwards, probably weeks or some later, you find yourself either being aware of certain things and invented your consciousness, but it's still there in the consciousness, even if it's controlled by the guide. So occasionally you do get certain things and you find yourself laughing. You know, you wonder what you're laughing at. And then all of a sudden you realize there's something there making you smile. What we have to do is to realize we must provide the right conditions. It's in fairness to the spirit, if they make the effort to come to us, we should make the effort to prepare ourselves. And so I believe that we should be not only dedicated, but be very sure of the situation, so that we are able to give the best. The idea of being the channel is to enable the spirit to use it properly. You must provide the spirit with things. They've got to have something up here so that they can use it. If there's nothing up here, it's very difficult for the spirit, because they can only use what we give to them, what we prepare for them. And some of the great mediums, trance mediums, I always remember that there was a very lovely old medium named Mrs. A.A. Ball. She always went by A.A. Ball. Amelia, her name was, and I don't think she liked Amelia. So she decided to use her too. She was Amelia Ann. So instead of saying Amelia Ann Ball, they used to call her A.A. Ball. And she liked that. Especially when she was 90. I mean, she didn't feel a bit like an Amelia at 90. And but she was a great lady. I wish you would have all had the privilege to meet her, because she seemed a little senile towards the end. And I used to feel very sorry for her. And I used to say, you know, it's not fair to invite this medium. It's not fair at all. I was saying it about me, you know that as well. You know, it's working them too hard. Because she always insisted on having 4 years' bookings ahead. When she was 18, she had 4. When she was 90, she had 4. When she died at 92, she still had 4 years. So she was looking ahead all right. She didn't believe she'd ever die, because she lived anyway. But she wanted to live, and she wanted to work. And when she came to the church where I belong, I was a person, she used to stay with my mother and I. And she used to come, and it took her all the time to climb stairs. She always had this lovely stick with the, what do you call it, that bone top, you know. I don't know what an ebony top. And used to wear amber beads. very people. And when he's used to bend that, he's thinking, good gracious, you're going to let her get up again. All these very human attitudes. And she was very fond of them, and she always wore them. And I went to help her, and she used to say, now, if you help me, I should be very offended. And I said, well, we've got to help you. So she said, no, I didn't need any help. When I need help, I should go across the other side. I don't want any help down here. That was a wonderful carriage, wasn't it, really? I was cheering for her, and I went to help her to the desk, the sort of stand there. And all at once she said, rather, she's under trance, and then realized she'd gone. Rather, leave the instrument alone. So she walked her way to the platform. She gave the most wonderful address. And she was 90 then. And it was so marvelous. I mean, the congregation was absolutely in tears. She was so brilliant and such a wonderful woman. I mean, she was very old, she'd gone, you know, old. And yet when she was under trance, she was brilliant. In control, wonderful flow of words. And I went to help her back again, and the guy said, brother, leave the instrument alone. Sat down, and then the same thing applied when she gave her demonstration, all at once she comes to life. Because it isn't the body that's being used, it's the other body. And that's the power that comes through. And that's because she was a great transmitter, wonderful transmitter. And she said to my mother, Fanny, my mother's name, Fanny, Fanny, when I go to the spirit world, I want to go working. And she did. She had given the address, had given a wonderful address in Salford, I believe, and the church where she was at, sat down. She was, the guide moved out, and as the guide moved out, he took her with him. And she couldn't get up to give the demonstration, she passed over. Mm-hmm. And the congregation was there, she passed as she wanted to. Full of life, you see, burning. And I thought that was. And they found her diary, 4 years' bookings. And you know, the great medium, R.J. Lees, wonderful trance medium, he was used in the Jeff River case, as you probably know. Wonderful medium. And, when he passed away, he was dying, he was 92. Isn't it funny, you get to 92, don't know how. Man, we should be lucky to get there. 92, he was brilliant. And the guide came through 92 as he was lying dying, so-called, and spoke to his family and gave them a marvelous talk. And said, we're taking you along with us. And he was in the unconscious state at the time. And then they took him in this unconscious state, they were talking, and they said, we'll bring your father to bid you his goodbyes, but he will never see you again. He's going to where he deserves to go, and that is much beyond. And he will not return to you there. He'll wait for you there. And he just closed his eyes. The guide came, the guide went, he came back, said his goodbyes, and just said, I'm going now. So it wasn't like a way to go. With everybody knowing you're going, stop a bit more, you know. Right, ladies and gentlemen, no one can promise with these things what's going to happen, or if they can. Mind you, I'd love to argue them if they don't, but very often we can find that it's a blank, and you can't force that. I do hope that you accept that situation, and if it doesn't go quite right, I hope that Jean will give you a demonstration. And you should not go out of the queue.
from this vast life of spirit, that together we may build the power that our world can be felt upon the world you live. For a while, all darkness is removed, and the light of love and reason prevails. I ask that you would put aside all things that may come between us. Who remember as we gain light from the same Father, we are one. We have the same opportunities and destinies. We have the same loving guidance from the Most High. We come together, united by the thought of love, by the thought of an eternal life. For as though the power has opened it, and we have entered therein, and we are drawn by this thought that links us in the great power of truth. And so the walls that surround you disappear. This is replaced by the power of those who come to you. For there is someone here that belongs to all of you, bringing with them their thoughts of caring and relationship, bringing with them the messages of hope and of cheer, that you may be gathered together in the power and the thought and the truth. Our world is very close to your world. They are separated only by the thought of death. There is within each one of you and our world the reality of a continuation of life, a life that never ends but only changes, a life of great experience from whence you have come and you will continue. For it is dropping away of those dense thoughts of an earthly life, passing through experience of soul journey, learning the great lessons of creation. The universe is calling to each one. For the great Lord and Master of life belongs to the whole. The law of attraction rules unerringly in our world. You you find yourself where you are best to feel. And you will find always that you will be surrounded by minds that are like your own. And those who are on the same level of evolution. There waits for you a tremendous journey of discovery, learning that you move along this path, many lessons of light. Life in many forms and in many existences. Life which will tell you always of the great might of the Spirit, moving you through the planes of life and planets of existence, to the great center sun of the whole universe itself. So that you will drop away those thoughts that darken that lies in the future ahead. Your families that you leave behind, that you will find in our world families once known before, those souls who prepared for your coming to this earth. The awakening of the soul and the beatings of life itself, moving over the great harmony of life. Awaits you all. That which you have built within your consciousness for the sum total of your life, where you feel the way you are, that you may find that waiting for you that will take you the many steps ahead. And those whom you love, who have moved beyond, the time has not removed them or moved them further from you. But you are able for a while to live your life together with them, you may experience that of oneness together. For if real love has been the key to your life, then the experience will be full of joy. But if for one moment there have been the shades of doubt, then you will see in the life that lies ahead purpose of their coming into your life, to teach you the many lessons of existence. Life unfolds like the flower when the sun awakens its reality, its petals open for the light to come. Death is but the opening of your soul to the reality of your life, that you may take in the spirit of all life and bring to you the greatness of self. The world you live passes passes through many changes. Some of you will lead the way to the changes which are here, and others will come to our world and witness the change their life made to the life which was there before they came to this world. For all you who come, the great power of the whole fits you to that part of which you must play. Then you will see it for yourself. Perhaps you have been used by the great master of the whole to weave the one, to make the path and open the path for those to come who will play their part in the great history of life. The great master that plans life knows the beatings of your heart, the pulsating of your soul, reason it is given to you to explore the realms of living. I come with the message of hope. For many of you who play a part in reaching the minds and the souls of people here. Some of you are coming to the close of those experiences. And you will come to play your part from our realm, to see the close and the closing of those windows of life where your light has been able to pierce the gloom. We bring to you the strength of belief. You must find that belief in your own being. Strength lies in the character that you have built of yourself. Find first the principle of life. The strength will come from the belief which lies deep within your being. Let the reflection of your soul impress on the vision of those who meet you of kindness and consideration and humility. Your world is a wonderful. For the breath of the Almighty and the Spirit that entered this earth from the universal life is bringing the color of life for all. Let each day be a day of loving, of the development of that spirit that lies deep within you. And let the words prayer, be the ordination of your being. If the words come from you, as you give yourself into God's keeping, that you may inspire mankind to greater things. I bring these words to you in love and ask that always you will realize the function of God in you. You're walking a path to find reality as the sonship of the Almighty. Then each day, grow in humility and in divinity. Do not come to our world to be divine, but to be divine here, that your light will open up the way beyond the world of tomorrow. I bring you the joys of knowing the Almighty is ever with you, for the caring of the souls of light and those who love you will ever be near to you. Look beyond to the highest of the high. Raise your eyes to the heavens. Your sight will return to where you are. For there is no beyond, only here. You go onwards, and yet you have never moved from the very place you stand. And let heaven and the joy be where you are. Search and find the hidden things of life in you. And the joy will be yours. You have the whole universe to search for truth. But it has no always been with you now. Life is an experience of great livings and great joys. You who serve the great master of life and his angels and those who give so much to life, never close the door, always keep it open. Through the crevice light comes through. The power of the divine upholds you. Do you follow me?
Yes, we do. Yes. Thank you very much, Chief.
It is good to be with those who serve.
Thank you.
And to meet friends. And to make friends. May the peace of the universe ever be with you. And obey the love that spans the universe. Hold you in its strength.
God bless you. Thank you, Mr. Chairman.
Yes.
Come through the hem of my hand.
Which blue?
Oh, good God, what are you doing here?
I come see you.
What are you doing here?
I come to see you.
What are you here for?
Hey, I want to say good afternoon to you
all.
Hey, there was some others stepped in before myself.
Yes, there was. I didn't quite get
there. I was queuing up and found there was another soul that's waiting. And I said, you should be behind the queue. You haven't been over long enough to come. And he says you'd know who it was.
I know Bill.
He said it was Bill Tyler.
Oh, yes. Good grief, yes, I will.
Oh, and he said he couldn't understand why it was that you didn't recognize
him.
Because you always used to say to him, speak up so I can hear you.
Yes.
because he had one of those soft voices where he never opened his mouth.
That's right, yes.
And he says he's been there many times when he used to talk with him.
Yes.
And there were some times he used to open so far to you, but no further.
Yes.
And he used to say, you know, that you'll have to speak up when you go to heaven, because if you ever come back, we'll never accept you. Now you listen to what
I'm listening to what you're saying.
And he hears that he's to tell Dorothy that he understands.
I understand that, yes.
Are you following
what
I've said to you?
I'm following what you said.
Are you sure you can hear every word I'm talking?
No, could you speak up?
You better find a trumpet that I can talk. I hope you can listen and hear what I want to say hello to you. And I can see there's a little lady sitting there, hello to yourself. And I have to tell you that I've got the joy for you because I've come with your father.
Oh, God, bless it.
And he said, it's about time you went and viewed the old place all over again.
Oh, yes.
Can you follow that?
Yes, I have to.
You're always talking about it, but you never do it.
That's true. That's true.
To understand it.
I do understand.
And he says some of the old places that he told you about are still there.
Yes,
if you'll only go and see.
I will go and see. I have thought.
Are you following now?
I am following.
Even to the old church where he was taken himself.
That's right, yes.
Are you listening?
Yes, I am listening.
And he says that your mother's still looking at him and she still adores him.
Oh, yes.
Can you follow?
Yes, I do.
When she came and left her to come to our world, it was as though a light had gone out in her own heart.
That's right, Father.
And you know very well that she never looked up from it. And always the conversation was about Dad.
Yes, that's right.
Are you following me?
Yes, I am following
you, Father. Everyone to see that it's nice to see you, but they don't like to see you with your feet as they are and your hands as they are and your head as it is. That your mother that's here, as you said, used to say to you, I don't know what you've got in that head, but it surprises me how you got it in there. Because you used to say things to us, used to say, I don't know what I'm listening to.
That's true, yes.
Can you follow me?
Yes, I can follow.
Well, we have to say that they've got a nice place prepared for you, but I have to tell you, it'll be another 20 to 30 years before you come. Are you following what I'm saying to you?
That's a relief, Paddy, I am
following. And we have to say that you'll always have enough to get you through when you want to stay where you are, because the time will come when you'll have a nice offer for the place.
Oh, yes.
But when you do, you'll have to clear what's at the top there.
Oh, yes, Paddy, I will. Yes.
Are you following what I'm saying?
I am following, yes, I am following.
Because the time will come when there will be great changes for you.
Oh.
But you have to wait because the right place that's coming along hasn't been built yet.
Oh.
Are you listening?
I am listening, yes.
So you can go away happy and know that you've had brought to you some of the things that are going to make you happy as you go along now.
Yes.
I have a gentleman here that says he's named after the whiskey and his name is Johnny Walker.
Johnny Walker?
Really?
He says he knows someone here named David.
Named what, Paddy?
David. David.
Johnny Walker.
Hey, there is someone that's got the name of David.
Yes.
And it's something to do with Manchester.
Yes.
Can we hear your voice now?
Yes.
Hey, there's a gentleman here that says he was John, but they used to call him Johnny. Did you know about him at all?
I can't place him, no.
Hey, well, you can go and ask about it, can you not?
I can, yes.
And you'll find they will talk to you about it because he often got it because of the whiskey that they call Johnny Walker.
Right.
Are you listening now?
I am, yes.
And we have to say you've had a little of a shock to think you're having a message from a ghost. Are you listening now?
I am, yes.
Alien and thinking to yourself, oh, I hope the time comes when I can do a lot of these things myself.
That's right, yes.
Are you listening?
I am, yes.
And we have to say that you've been to visit a place somewhere, or you know someone to do a sale more.
That's right, yes.
Are you listening?
I am, yes.
And I have to say to you that you have visited this place yourself.
Yes.
And when you do, you go all the way to Chester.
Okay.
Are you listening?
I am, yes.
I think you can hear that in your side as well. Hey, we have to say that the family have come to see you because your grandfather and your father, the gentleman that we've given to you, was your great-grandfather.
Right, okay.
Do you understand that?
Yes, I do.
Because your grandfather's here and he says that it was his father.
Right.
So you've now got it, have you not now?
I have, yes.
And I'll tell you something else as well, that he was a man that worked very hard.
Yes.
There were hard days, and he used to work quite a lot at night as well. Are you listening?
I am, yes.
Have to be sure that you're listening. Are you listening?
I am, yes.
And we have to say that you visited a house in Temple Road or Temple Street.
That's correct.
And you've been to visit someone there.
Yes.
And you've spoken of someone, is it Noreen?
What name?
Is it Noreen or Doreen?
Yes.
And we have to say as we're coming to you that you have many visions and many thoughts in your life, and there's many things you could have done. But at the last moment you have cold feet about it, because you haven't been sure about it.
That's right, yes.
Are you following?
I am, yes.
You like to feel that the life you've got is all right, but you'd like to change it, but you want it for better and not for worse.
That's correct.
You understand what I'm talking about?
Yes, I do.
And you're beginning to put a little bit by you now, but it's been difficult in the past to be able to build anything like a little fortune.
That's correct.
Your father?
I do.
He's got a little bit in the bank now. Oh, I can follow what I'm saying. And what's the knocking that goes next door to yourself?
I don't hear any.
There's some noise that comes through the wall there.
Oh, yes. I make too much noise myself.
Well, I can tell you that 133 doesn't like it at all. Are you listening to what I'm saying?
Yes, I am.
Because you know 133, do you not know?
I do, next door to me.
Well, they very often just tell you about the noise sometimes.
They do.
You follow them.
I do.
And your grandfather comes to see you and says he's at it again now. Hope you're following what I'm saying.
I am, yes, thank you.
But you've got it very nice. You don't need anyone to go round and do anything after you've done it yourself, because I'm told by your grandmother that you bottom everything.
Yes, that's right.
You like to get everything from the bottom. I don't know what she means, but she says she bottoms everything.
Yes.
He has a good clear out and starts from the top to the bottom. Do you not know?
I do, yes.
And then when he's done it, he looks at it and says, I'll leave it for a week, but I'm going to do it again. Are you listening?
I am, yes.
And I can see that you've had some new carpet, by the way.
Yes.
And we want to say to you that you've been getting everything nice, because you like to have everything nice, so if anybody comes, they can feel that you've been working on it.
That's right, yes.
You understand that?
Yes.
Hey, but there are a lot of things you'd like to do with it as well.
Yes.
But it takes money to do it, does it not, sir?
It does, yes.
And you say, I'm not going to do it if somebody else is going to benefit from it. I want to benefit from it myself.
That's right.
Hey, well, we have to bring this to you and to see that your eyes are getting open to many things.
Yes.
And you've prayed and thanked the Spirit for guiding you in the right direction, but sometimes you've hit up against some people that have tended to make you feel a little bit disappointed in them.
Yes.
Are you listening?
I am, yes.
And then you pray at night time and say, Although I'm going to sleep, I want to waken up tomorrow to a better day than today.
Yes.
And you're always saying to yourself, and I hope that there are powers that will come into my life that will give me the spirit that I'm looking for.
Yes.
Have you got it all now?
Yes, I have, thank you.
Anyway, I have to tell you that the house that's next door, 133, that you're the one that's down below it, so you must be 131.
I am, yes.
And the house that you visit when you go away to Salemore is number 11.
Yes.
Anyway, I have to say that they wanted to bring it to you so you'd understand you are being watched.
Thank you.
And the Spirit has guided you and they'll guide you again.
Thank you.
So that you're building your life and it will open up for you. Are you following me?
I am, yes.
You seem to go around the back of your house more than you go into the front of it.
Yes.
Because you're on a main road.
That's correct.
And there's so much traffic that goes past that if you wanted to leave a car at the front, you'd have to keep looking at it to see if it'd been hit. Are you listening?
I am, yes.
That's why you go around the back to those gates at the back there.
Yes.
Is it right now?
It is, yes.
Hey, we have to say that they've been waiting for a long time to cheer you up now.
Thank you.
And to make you feel that you're on the right road after all.
Thank you very much.
And that your heart has been full and sometimes it's been near to the breaking point and you know it.
Yes, I do.
But your strength has been able to get you through.
Yes.
And when you look at yourself through the mirror, you can see yourself looking better. He's a nice looking chappy now, is it not? He's got a nice pale skin. Are you following?
Yes, ma'am.
And he keeps his hair quite nice, you see. So he looks after himself to make himself presentable. He likes them to go up to him and to give him a nice little hug now and then. Are you following what I'm
talking? I am, yes.
Well, we have to say it is very nice to be able to come and see you all and to be able to be with you. And we have to say that there is someone here, and she's Jean now, because there's an aunt here that wishes to be remembered to her.
Yes, thank you, Paddy.
And we have your voice now.
Yes, Paddy, thank you, Paddy.
Hey, you've got an aunt that wishes to be remembered to you.
Yes.
And she says that while you are still here, every time they see your mother and their aunts.
Yes.
Yes. Are you following what I'm saying, Bert?
Yes, Paddy, yes.
And we have to say that she might be a little small, but there's a lot of good in small people. Can you hear what I'm saying
yes,
to you?
Yes, thank you, Paddy, yes.
And you try to smile as much as you possibly can.
Yes.
Is it right,
yes,
sir?
That's right, yes.
Hey, we have to bring this to you. And you've been speaking to someone with a name like Mustard.
I don't know.
Or is it something to do with the name of Mustard? We have to say that you've been talking to someone with something to do with Mustard now.
Somebody
tell them? Hey, but it is the lady knows the person concerned now.
Oh, yes.
Yes, the person by that name.
Yes,
here.
I have been, yes. I didn't know her name when I spoke to her.
Hey, but you've been speaking to her
yes.
about some of the experiences you've had yourself.
Yes.
Is it right now?
Yes.
Because while you were talking to her, you were talking about London where you're not now.
Yes, I did talk about London.
Because she doesn't live far away.
Yes, yes.
Is it right now?
Yes, that's
right. Well, where's the lady that you've been talking to?
She's there.
I'm here, Marley Cole.
Yes. Hey, but you've been talking to this lady named Jean now.
Yes.
Is it right now?
Yes, it is, honey.
And you've been talking about a park. That you've been saying something about a park which is close to you.
Yes, that's right.
And you were asking her about it.
Yes.
Can you follow? Because you used to say that there was a very nice park close by.
Yes, that's right.
And that when you wanted a little bit of peace or quiet, you tried to go into the park.
Yes.
But you didn't find it always convenient to go.
That's true.
But you could see it because it isn't far from you.
That's right.
Are you listening?
I am.
Hey, we have to say to you that you've been saying to yourself, I've got to get myself so that I can experience these things myself.
That's right.
And you say that I don't care what it takes, I'm going to stick to it until I've found it.
That's right.
But you found it difficult until recent times to be able to offer it.
That's quite true.
Because you still had a lot to do and you still have. But you're beginning to learn a lesson, you're looking after yourself more than you were doing a few years ago.
That's exactly right.
Can you follow? Yeah. And we have to say you know something about a place and you live in a flat, do you not know?
Yes, I do.
And we've got a very nice flat because you can go right from the street onto it.
Yes.
Is it right?
Yes.
And you've got some nice grass around there.
Yes.
Because they take the dogs for a walk.
Yes.
Are you listening?
Not mine, but yes.
Eh, but you see them going with the dogs walking on the grass.
That's correct.
You follow?
Yes.
And you can see through your window, can you not now?
Yes, I can.
And you know many of the people because they're regular to time, you see they're off again. I hope you're listening.
Yes, I am.
Eh, we want to see that your family come to see you in the house of where you are.
Yes, I know that.
And it makes the house nice and full and you can hear laughter many times.
Yes.
And you know it's of the spirit.
That's right.
Are you following now?
Yes.
And you've got some nice things around your house and some nice pictures.
Yes,
because you like nice pictures to look at.
Yes.
And you put them on the wall in a special place so that wherever you turn you've got a view of some kind.
Yes, that's quite correct.
And we can see it with you. In your flat, and you sometimes have two lots of curtains to your windows.
Yes.
Because you like to keep them drawn back until you have to close them, but you don't like to close them until you've got forced onto you.
That's quite right.
But you put something down because there are people that pass your window, and before you had those drops, they used to look in and used to say to yourself, there's not a bit of privacy at all.
Are you
listening?
Yes, I am.
We have a gentleman here that's come to our side after a very serious illness indeed. That needed a lot of care and a lot of looking after for quite a long time. And he's here and he belongs to you.
Yes.
And he's here because he says that he walks beside you. And he wants you to know that the power that brought you into the world and tried to care for you, still cares for you on our side of life.
Thank you.
Are you listening?
Yes.
And that the tears of your shed because of the sorrow you passed through are turning to tears of joy because you can see in your sorrow some of the joy that now is with you.
That's right.
Can you follow them?
Yes.
And we have to say to you, they want you to look up and to look around and to be part of all life. Because you'll play your part in your own way.
Yes.
And you'll be drawn to the people that will matter to you.
Thank you.
And you'll find yourself making friends and companionship will come your way.
Thank you.
Are you listening?
Yes.
So you'll go away happy, will you not now?
I certainly will, Connie.
And you'll be able to take the job. And remember that if you're wanting to look at someone very nice on your wall, all you have to do is to look at one of your pictures and place myself there. And if you find that you can look at the most handsome man that you've ever seen, and then put some lovely red hair on them, and that's myself. I listen.
Yes.
And if that doesn't do anything for you, there's nothing in the world that'll help. I hope you can follow what I'm saying to you.
Okay.
It's nice to see you because they want you to be happy now. And to realize that you've got to keep the shape you've got, because it'll mean changing everything again. Are you listening?
Just about.
Can keep yourself as you are for a while. There's no use changing those wardrobes because you've too many you'd have to change.
Oh, I knew that.
Hey, the little girl's just been along to see the place where you are. And it seems a block of flats here.
Yes.
And it seems to stand just slightly away from a road, of which is quite a wide road here.
That's right.
And we can see that there is something to do with Kensington there.
Exactly right.
And it is Kensington Park Place or something.
Road.
Well, that's where you are. And you're not too far along away from the park itself.
That's right.
You understand now?
Yes, it's right up.
Well, she's been to see it and she says that you've got some small flowers in a little vase.
Yes.
Are you listening?
Yes.
So she's touched them to let you know that she's been there.
Thank you.
I hope you can follow.
Yes, I can.
Yes, I have to come back to the lady named Jean now.
Oh, thank you, Paddy.
Because you were just getting a little disappointed that I had left you. Are you following now? Because I've been sending your thoughts out about your mother now.
Yes,
sir. Is that right now?
Yes.
Because a lady has just arrived here and she says she's come because of your thoughts. Are you listening now?
Yes, yes, Paddy.
And she says, I wouldn't have missed her for anything now. But she's talking about a very strange name here that only has three letters in it.
Yes.
Are you listening?
Yes, Paddy.
And she says that there are quite a few of them on her side of life and it's our side of life.
Yes.
That have this name and there's only a few of you left now. Eh, but it's not as many that's come across now. Are you listening now?
Yes, yes.
And I have to say to you that there's many a time as you've been travelling in dream state.
Yes.
Because you find that sometimes you can't get what you want in the normal state. So you say, well, here I am, if you want to use me well and then let me have some nice dreams, I'll be happy. And you very often have nice experiences in the dream state.
Yes, I do.
Are you listening?
Yes.
And while this is going on, they're reaching you inside because they're making you stronger to face up to life.
Oh, thank you.
Are you listening?
Yes, I am. Happy.
Because there's many times when you weaken, and you know you do.
Yes.
And when you weaken, you know very well yourself that you come through those times of when things just seem just to be too hard for you to be able to cope with.
That's true, yes.
Able, they brought you the strength and they say, please yourself, and you're weighing up and you've been looking in your bank book.
Yes.
Saying to yourself, I won't be able to do all the things, but I'm going to do some of the things. And what's the use of leaving it behind because I'll only spend it, I might as well spend it myself. Are you listening? And we want you to look after yourself and spiritualize yourself and bring it more into your life. And you'll find that you'll be able to cope with the situations around yourself.
Yes, thank
you, Paddy. Do you understand me?
Yes, I do, Paddy, yes.
Hey, we have somebody here that's talking to us. It is said they come from Lancaster. And there is someone that's got a feather on our side of life.
Yes.
Can we have a voice now?
Yes.
Hey, but it's to do something to do with Lancaster.
I've just moved there.
Hey, we have to say that they travelled with you. Are you listening?
Yes.
Because there's a gentleman here that belongs to yourself.
Yes.
And is talking about the past and the present and what you intend to do in the future.
Yes.
And we have to say there's a gentleman named Bill that wishes to be remembered to you.
Yes.
That's on our side of life.
Yes.
Are you listening?
Yes.
And you've made these changes because they were more or less not forced onto you, but it was the way that opened up for you.
True.
And now you've got it, you're looking back to see if it was all the right things to do at the time.
Right.
Are you listening? That's why they've come to see you, to put you at ease. And to say to you that these things come because they will open the way that will change many things in your own life. Are you listening?
Yes, thank you.
Because some of the things you thought were going to happen have not arrived yet. You're waiting for them to come.
That's right.
Are you listening?
Yes.
And we have to say here that here goes another one now. That you must live in a building of buildings now.
Yes.
Is it right?
That's correct.
And we have to say that you've moved to a place that's named, they tell us, after a lake.
Thank you.
I can't tell you what it is, but I know it's something to do with the lake.
That's right.
I'll send the little girl to find out all about it. But it's quite a new place.
We're 10 years old.
Are you listening?
Yes.
Because they want me to tell you that you'll be able to see the roses blooming.
Yes.
And it will do your heart good to have a change.
Always best.
Are you listening?
Yes.
So we want you to know they've come to see you because they want to place you on the path, and the longest path you'll travel until you reach your dream.
Thank you.
Have you followed what I've said to you?
Yes.
So keep your dream in your mind and your heart and keep going onwards now.
Thank you.
Here we have to tell you that you haven't quite settled down at the present time.
Okay.
But you've got things still that have got to be put right where you're living now. Because you've just settled it down and you keep looking at it to see if there are other things you've got to get.
True.
Do you understand now?
Yes.
I'm told to tell you to leave just alone at the present time. Because other things will come that will add to it. Are you listening?
Yes.
We want you to go away and take up the threads again now, so that you'll be able to weave the pattern of your life.
Thank you.
Yes, I have just been talking to those that are here, and they think that I've used the body long enough.
That's right.
I hope that you will understand you.
Certainly.
You follow me.
Yes.
Take away with yourselves now the blessings and the power that we bring to you. You have to come back. We want you to tell that the instrument that I'm using,
yes.
Will you just tell him that we love him and that we'll look after you?
Yes.
We'll
do that.
towards the twin crown.
Yes.
Does no one here knows someone named, I think it's Elizabeth Bain or Baines or Ban, something like that? It's named Elizabeth, this lady.
Could be Grimes, could it? Grimes.
Oh, would you know that name?
I would know it, yeah.
Well, this lady that I seemed to find with me as I was coming back asked me to convey this to you. And to say that she was talking about Harry, someone named Harry, and he's someone that's passed over but some time ago. His name would be Henry, but they called him Harry.
I can't place that.
But there is someone named George that's living, and there's a Harry that belongs there. So George and Harry must be connected together. Do you think that is correct?
I'll need to think about it.
Will you try to do that? But this lady definitely came and she was talking, she was trying to convey something about someone going into hospital and they're preparing to go into hospital. There's someone here and it's something to do with her family. Could you possibly remember what I've given to you?
I'll try to.
Do you hold a circle anywhere yourself? Do you hold a circle?
No, I don't hold a circle.
At any time have you done so?
No.
Have you been involved in one?
I only go to the next level of the church.
Is there anybody here that knows a name similar to theirs?
Well, we
know
the surname
Bain.
We
do.
A number of our circle is called Ken Bain.
And now then, could you tell me if there's a lady that's passed away belonging to them?
I don't know.
Is there a way of finding out?
Yes.
Do try and if you can, but there's something to do with the hospital. And somebody going in. I tried to hold on to it as much as I could, but it's not funny to me. I don't understand. But it definitely was there. I have an idea.
Ladies and gentlemen, would you like to show your appreciation? Keep your seats while Mr. Higginson and everybody leaves the platform. But you know, Gordon, thank you for being here this week.
Good pleasure.
And really, you know, he is the finest medium we've got. Right?
Good work.
Straight to the blue room, there's some tea there for you.
Okay, you can smile.
It's subject to what's